Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back to more Ark Survival Evolved here on the Dodo Loco server. Guys, I really hope you're having a great day and thank you so much for tuning in to today's episode. Guys, again, I do apologise for the lack of Ark content I have been providing for you guys here on the channel, but I still have the builders in. I'm basically having a brand new lounge, so recording videos is really, really hard at the minute. But guys, if you have stuck around, thank you so much. We are so close to 3,600 subscribers. It's absolutely incredible. Thank you all so much, and let's get started with today's episode. So, in between the episodes, guys, because it has been a while, what I've been doing is I've raised this building one more higher. And what I said I was going to do is put our Rexes in, which is what I've done. We've only got the three Rexes, because our best Rex is over there with the Bionic Rex skin. So, we've just got three Rexes in here. Got this little sort of walkway that goes up here, and it's just got our feeding troughs. Each end, and I've put a trophy with a alpha. I killed another alpha Rex, so I got the skull. So I think it really fits the theme of, you know, putting the T-Rexes in the T-Rex shed with the alpha Rex skull on the wall. So that is what I've been doing there. In regards the base, all I've done in here is simply changed up the smithy room, the crafting room. So I've added some extra storage. We've got our bookcase there, so it just gives us a bit more extra storage. I've renamed everything, guys, so we've got like pearls, pelt, chitin, keratin, gunpowder, all them kind of good things. So that is that little room right there. The greenhouse, I have extended the greenhouse up to another level. So down here we've got all our veggies growing up nicely. Come up the stairs in the corner, and then you've got like narcos, mayhos, and there is some more crops here as well. So I raised it one higher and just put an extra floor on it. I think it looks really, really nice. It adds that aesthetically pleasing purpose to the build. And it's an all-in-all functional greenhouse. You've got your dung beetle in here and you've got your poo factory there. So it's such an effective greenhouse. It's brilliant. I absolutely love it. So that is that. What else have I been doing off the camera? Like I said, I named all the chests, so everything has got a name on it. I still can't have names on my HUD at the moment because my game just fucking lags out to shit, man. So, but if we go in here, what I've done in here is made ourselves a little trophy room. So these were the trophies that we got last episode. This purple one right here. That was the one we got a while ago. So I've just laid them all out, and then if you come up the stairs, this just takes us up to our little watchtower. So I really like it. I really do like it. One more thing, guys, before we get on with today's episode, is you remember the plant species X that I put on the corners of the wall? Well, I've actually gone and changed it up now, guys. And also, I've took the doors out of here and just put one door slap bang in the middle. You know me, guys. It has to be in the middle. I think it looks really, really nice, and we're going to get on with this today. I've flipped the walls. This took me fucking ages to do because this is going to be an interior wall, so I wanted the wood panel to show through. So I've had to go around and change all the walls. So I've put spike walls all the way around the outside now. But you're probably wondering about the plant species X. Well, I've put a little door here on each corner of the wall. I've put a little door that I can get into, and there is a generator. The generators are all full of gasoline, and they are all attached to auto turrets. Now, I wanted to show you guys me putting some auto turrets in, but because of the time and, you know, I haven't had time to record, etc., it's just been a bit of a ball ache. So I've got auto turrets on every corner. I've got two over here. As you can see, they're doing their job nicely. They're both powered, and they're all on, like, attacking wild dinos and close range or far range or something like that. But they protect the base so much, and you know, I've been crafting up all the advanced rifle ammo, gunpowder. I've just been logging on every day, getting the charcoal, you know, and then getting the gunpowder, making up the bullets, doing a metal run while I've just been not able to record. So that is what I've been doing, guys. I've got loads of stuff in the chest ready for today's episode, because we're going to start the first floor of our egg farm. So we're going to see how far we get with that. and we're going to see about looking for a Therizinosaurus. I did watch a couple of videos on the Therizinosaurus, and it looks like an amazing dinosaur. So what I've had to do is make this little pen out here, because obviously if we go too close, everything's going to get annihilated. And yeah, so hopefully we can drop the dino in here, tame it up, and then carry it back out with no problem at all. There are little pegamastics that, you know, rob you, but we're not going to look at them today. I'm interested in the Therizinosaurus. So that is enough from me, guys. I've been rambling on. I'm going to go and get ready, and then we're going to go and make a start on the first floor of our egg farm. So give me a couple of seconds, guys, and we'll be right back. Okay, so I've got some materials in. I've got the walls, the ceilings, the slope triangles, and the slope walls. What I want to do is try and keep this area sort of free so we can just sort of, you know, come in. What I might do is just build like a wall. In fact, that is what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to build a wall going around, and then we can just go in and up the ladder. Garden protects it. Actually, I'm not going to do that now. So let's try and get this first floor in. So I've had a play around and I realised that the ceilings don't snap properly. I think there's multiple snap points. So what I'm going to have to do is kind of build like that. And then I'm going to try and put a triangle on the edge like so, with the ramp going up. And then what I'm going to do is try and put the ceiling on the top. See, now it snaps properly. See, that is what I'm looking for. So the dino is going to come up, sit on the top, and then the eggs should roll down here. Now, I don't know why that's done that for. I wonder if it will snap a bit further over, possibly. Like that. I think they generally do just overhang. All right, so that's fine then. So if we put we could put a wall there, well, a door going up. So let's just... I haven't got a door frame. Have I got enough to make a door frame? No, I haven't. Not yet. All right. So let's not worry about that for now then. So let's just carry on building this out. Probably only going to do four for now. See how that looks. Obviously, I need to come out this side. Otherwise, we'll get stuck. So let's put another triangle. Is it going to snap in the right place for me? That one. That one. There we go. Nice. Alright, so let's put these on then. Perfect. And it's raining. Nice. Nice. So yeah, like I said, the dinos should come up here. And that's it. Get in your snap point. Get in the snap point. So the dinos will... Dinos will stand up here. The egg should roll down. And that'll be all around the outside. We've got enough to run around. And then the middle part, we can put, you know, like our oviraptors in and everything like that. So we've got four for now. Let's go and get a couple of dinos and sort of see what we're looking at for sort of room and stuff like that. So I think we should go and get the carnos. Possibly. Let's move this guy out of the way. So, if we put him there, let's say, for now. So, the tails are going to be a bit of an issue, but I think we can, because of I've made the wall double thick, it doesn't matter if their heads stick through the door. It doesn't really matter. Oh, and I'm hungry. Get some food. Oh, I'm stuck as well. There's too many dinos. Here we go. Here we go. We're out. So let's move this guy, because he's a bit all over the place at the moment. I mean, I don't want him really to be like... I mean, that's how I want him, like, but I don't know why he's all limpy for. He's all sort of like on his side. Not really too sure what's going on there. So let's put the other carno up then. Oh god. The lag, man. I don't know why we're lagging for. I've got everything turned off. Alright, so we might be able to push him up a little bit further. like that. They just seem to be all bendy. Not too sure as to why they're all sort of bendy, but I'm sure we can sort that out. So the tails are now out the way. So I think we'll be able to get quite a lot in. So what I'm going to do is finish off the bottom floor, bring you guys back, and we'll see where we are. So I'll catch you in a couple of seconds, guys. Alright guys, so this is what I've got going on. I kind of got a bit carried away doing the off-camera stuff. But the Carnos are in and their eggs do roll down the balcony. I've sort of put a pillar going in here just sort of to, you know, keep this separate. I'm thinking of moving this door over one and then sort of squaring this off in here and have sort of, you know, like another mini breeding area, just like a mating area, because we've got that over there. But then to keep bringing the dinos in and out, it's going to be a bit of a pain. So I thought we could just sort of, you know, box this area off and do like a little mini mating area, and then obviously we can have one more slope wall there. I brought the aloes in. I'm not too sure if I'm going to keep the aloes in here. I think they're a bit too big for what I wanted. Because obviously we're going to go a little bit higher, put a roof on, and then obviously the birds will be on the top. I like it, but... Oh God, there's a fucking fertilized egg in there. I like it. As I was saying, so I like it. I don't know. Is it too big? Is it too big for what I need? Obviously, we're getting eggs. Eggs are good. Good old egg. Touchy egg. Carno egg. We're getting eggs. Eggs for days here, guys. But what? Let me know what you think in the comment section. Do you like it? Is there room for improvement? I think there is. I might bring the aloes back up. So like I say, they're a bit too big. And what I might do is bring it in one and make it a little bit smaller. I think it's a bit too big for what we need, I think, guys. Maybe bring it, keep them in. Maybe bring it to here. So bring it in, and then obviously we can just bring that out a little bit more. Yeah, I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do that off camera, I think. It's a bit too big for what we need. But I did get all the dinos in. Obviously, we just need somewhere now for our sort of mammals, non-egg layers. So I can build something for them. You never know. We might be able to build something similar in here. If we have the egg farm, probably... We could probably have the egg farm going all on one side, like half of it. And then this side, we could have all the non... Ooh. Aloe egg. If I bring the aloes back in, and if I can squeeze all these guys in, that would be pretty cool. And then we could possibly have all the mammals on this side. So I'm going to have a little bit of thinking. I'm not 100% happy with it. Definitely not. But we've made a good start, guys. We have made a good start on this egg farm. I am going to go and look around for a Therizinosaurus. I did say I want to have a look around for one of them today. So I need to get equipped with all my tranks and everything. We're going to go out. We're going to go on the hunt. So I'm going to get some more food and water as well, guys. So I don't know. You need to let me know what you think about this, guys. I think I might leave it the build there for now. I think I'm going to bring it in one. I think it might be a bit too big. So I'm going to bring it in one. And then we'll see what we're looking at there. Might do it off camera very, very quickly for you guys. And then we'll see what we do. I want to go out and have a look for a Therizinosaurus though. So that is what I'm going to do right now. We're going to take a break from the building. So I'm going to get equipped up, guys. And then I'm going to go out and hunt. So hopefully I'll catch you guys in a little while. Alright guys, holy shit, check this out. I was just flying around and I come across this beast. It's a female 120 raptor. Oh my god, this is going to be amazing. Unfortunately, I don't have the kibble for it, which is parasaur kibble. I don't have any, but I think with our stats on the server, that's a bit of a blow to the head. With our stats on the server, he should, or she should, tame out pretty quick just using the prime meat. There was a stego around here somewhere. There he is. I'm gonna go get that stego. Is that a stego there as well? What's that? Oh, it's a stego. 12. Let's make sure this stego is a low level before we go and get it. Yeah, 16. We could do with some stegos. Definitely could do with some stegos, but unfortunately, this one is going to be raptor food. I found some Troodons as well, but I don't think we're going to be taming up any Troodons as of yet. No way. We need some bigger tames, man, because you got to feed them. You got to feed them your tames. And it's just going to be a bit of a ball egg. That is going to be one hell of an episode, trying to tame a pack of Troodons. I mean, with our stats on the server, we might get away with, being able to do it quite quickly. But, can we land? I don't know. It's going to be one of them things. But I can't believe I found a 120 Raptor. That is unbelievable. Alright, so let's get the prime meat off of this guy then. So we want prime. We shouldn't lose any levels, really. Oh, we've only got a little bit of prime. Damn. Yeah, like I say, we shouldn't lose any levels for this guy. So let's just chuck all of that on there. 99, yeah, there we go. So it should be 179. It is. Awesome. Awesome. So let's get him to stop. Let's take out our stuff. Nice. All right. What are the stats? So I'm not too bothered, to be honest, about the stats. But, 1,200 health to boot is pretty good. Nearly 250 melee damage as well. Not too bad. Not too bad. Right. I'm going to get this guy put in the base. And then we're going to carry on looking for that Therizinosaurus. Have we got him? Yeah, there we go. Alright guys, I'll catch you in a minute. Alright guys, check it out. Our luck is in. Look at this. 120 male Therizinosaurus. Holy shit. We need to go and swipe him up. Fuck, our luck is in. Now I know these guys deal torpor. I've had a couple of run-ins with them on another server that I play on. And they destroy stone. But guys, fuck, 120, shit. I don't even know what kibble these guys take. I need to have a look. I'm going to try and get this guy back to our little taming pen. And I'm going to chuck him in. And I need a... Oh, look, there's some jellyfish. Oh, wow. Man, there's so much to explore. Holy shit, I can't believe it, guys. So, hold on. We've got a 120 Raptor and a 120 Therizinosaurus. There was two down there. But the other one was only, like, level 8 or something. Holy. I'm really hungry as well. Oh, my God. Everything's all loading in. Damn, we're laggy. As soon as I put him down, he is going to rip that little pen apart. I'm just looking on the Dodo Dex app, and by the looks of it, he takes Megalosaurus kibble, which we don't have, but you can feed it crops. Alright, let's chuck it in. Oh, it's such a nice colour. Is he gonna go in? Go in, go in, go in. No! Oh man, come on, just go in, just go in. Holy, you in? No, last try. This is insane, guys. Go on, now get in. Yes. Right, we need to knock this guy out because he will start breaking our stuff. He is gorgeous. He is gorgeous. All right. Here we go. Ooh. Ooh, man. Oh, my God. I hope we don't lose any levels off of it. That would be a shame, man. 120. Beast. I don't think he's damaging our... I've read that they damage stone. Oh, that was a miss, weren't it? I'm scared because them little guys that come and rob you, they're around here somewhere. I don't want them to rob me. Ah, there we go. Let's see. He's damaging our stuff. Not a lot, but he's damaging it nonetheless. Come on, just go down, man. Just go down. Finally! Jesus! He took a good lot of darts there. Alright, so he's down. Look at the colour of him. Oh man, he is gorgeous. Alright, so what we kind of look... Oh, am I stuck? No! Oh, please don't tell me I'm stuck, man. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh, I am well and truly stuck. let's see if we can get the Quetzal over. Oh, man. Come on. Come on, Quetzal. Do me proud. Oh, he's following medium as well. No. That's it. Come here. No. Yes. Yes. Alright, guys, we got out. Right, so let's check the stats of this guy then. Because I'm not too sure what the torpor's like on him either. Torpor's going down. Can I access the inventory? There we go. Right, guys, so to boot, we got 4,000 health. 660 stamina, 452 weight, 175 melee damage, and 100% movement speed. Oh, whoa. Have I just been robbed? No. Ooh, I thought I just got robbed. Quetzal, what are you doing? Right, I need some crops, man. Right, I'm going to go get some crops, guys. And I'll be right back. Alright guys, so any second now, the Ferrozenosaurus should be tamed up. We've still got 99.9% taming effectiveness and plus 59 levels. What I've done while I've been waiting is put windows all the way around the bottom. Put a door in there, because I believe the Pegamastix can actually get out of a, you know, one foundation wide door. We could probably use this with the Troodon as well, if we built a platform where we can chuck stuff into. Because Troodons have to eat a certain amount of XP before they get tamed. So Dodos isn't going to cut the mustard, I don't think. What are we looking? Oh, I've probably got one more bite left on this guy. Yeah, so I don't think Dodos are going to cut the mustard with the Troodon. But I know that the Pegamastix does take crops. And there was a level 8 and a level 12 over there. But I don't want to put them in here yet. Because although the Ferrozenosaurus is outside, he's still technically registered as inside there. So we'll wait for him to get up. And we'll just leave him to one side. And I'm fucking stuck again. We'll leave him to one side. And then we'll get the Pegamastix. So I'm hoping that this guy's going to tame up any second. There we go. We've got it. We've tamed a Ferrozenosaurus. Nice. So let's whistle passive. Let's whistle stop. I'm going to have to go get the Quetzal to lift him out. What are we looking at for kind of like stats then? Let's put the saddle on him. Nice. Let's get out these and them. All right. So, guys, we got 4,872 health, 930 stamina. 511 weight, 266.9% melee damage. And now that is a perfect tame Ferrozenosaurus. Not kibble tamed, crop tamed. But due to our settings, we're able to do that. So let me go get the Quetzal. Let me go get him out. In fact, we'll go do that now, very, very quickly. And then we'll go look for some Pegamastix. Bear in mind, the game is gonna lag like fuck. Let's go. Let's go and get this guy out. And then we can go look for some Pegamastics. Come on. You out? Did I get ya? No, of course I didn't get ya. So guys, what did you think about the egg farm? Let me know. Did I get ya? Yeah. Let me know in the comment section, guys. I mean, I don't know. I really don't know. Alright guys, so we are back and I've had a look at the time and we are running out, so I'm going to have to end the video very soon. But in the next episode guys, we will carry on where we left off. We're going to go take out the Therizinosaurus out for a spin, because guys, I didn't even realise that it's got like a special sort of wheel on it. Let me try and find it. There, look, view harvesting level. So every level you put into this guy, it's kind of like the moss chops, you know, you can get additional delicate harvesting or additional power harvesting. So there's lots to sort of have a look at with the Therizino. So we're going to take him out next episode. He is awesome. I really, really, really do like the colours that we've got going on with this guy. It's sort of like the blue, the green, the black. He looks absolutely awesome. Go on, swipe him. Get him. Get him. He looks absolutely awesome and I love him. No, don't get the map out, you idiot. So, as you can see, I've made a little bit of changes to the egg farm. Let's go and have a look inside. So, first of all, you'll notice that it looks a little bit shorter. I've took out a row of foundations out the back and just brought it back one. It took a little while, but I think it looks a lot better now. It's a lot more compact. We've got a whole row here for dinos, whole row here for dinos. Got the dimorphs in and everything. Everything's still in the middle. As you can see, the roof is sloped now, going in one. So the idea is to put a row of flat ceilings in, normal ceilings in, and then another row of slope ceilings. And then have like a hole in the middle so our quetzals can sort of hang their butts over the edge. And hopefully lay eggs, which will drop down into this area here. So we can just go around and pick them up. That is what I'm hoping for anyway. It's big enough to fit a couple of quetzals on for sure. So that is what I've got going on. This bit over here, obviously no ceiling snap to the slope roofs, unfortunately. So I'm going to have to sort of makeshift a sort of walkway. And then obviously we'll be able to fit these slope roofs on. Not the slope roof, the ceilings on, because they won't just snap straight onto the slope roof. So we need to have some sort of snap point, hence why I've got that wall up there, so everything will snap around on that one wall. But I need to take out this row here, because that will go over to in the Carno bit here. So we just kind of need it just one going over. So I'm going to sort that out off the camera. So that is the egg farm. It's looking pretty good. It's looking pretty good. All the eggs are coming out. I'm not going to pick these ones up because I've got so many eggs. Well, I haven't got trike eggs though. That is what we want, trike eggs. So yeah, everything is looking really, really good. And I really like it. And the fog's setting in. So next episode, guys, we will carry on with the egg farm. We will go and look for the Pegamastics, definitely. We definitely want some Pegamastics. And I might take the Pharaoh out. I'm definitely going to take the Pharaoh out for a bit of a harvest and try and get some levels into him. Might try and breed up the Rexes again. I just kind of felt this episode was a bit all over the place. I don't know if you're with me on that, guys, but it just felt like it was a little bit all over the place. I think that's what we get for not recording for a while, isn't it, mate? That is it. What are we going to call this guy? Put some names in the comment section down below, guys, and you know, I'll be sure to try and name this guy on one of the best suggestions that you guys give me. It's a male. So do let me know, guys. Do let me go. Hello. It's me. So, yeah, I just felt like this episode was a little bit all over the place. But, you know, I haven't recorded in such a long time. It's hard to try and remember where we left off, what we need to do, what we haven't done. And I forgot to say at the start of the videos, rest in peace to the fallen comrades. of our Team Hardcore crew who died in the Kano Cave last episode. I did totally forget all about that. See, that's what you get, guys, for not recording. So next episode is going to be more structured to it. I'm going to plan it out. And the episode after that, it's going to be absolutely awesome, guys. So I think I'm going to end it there. That's enough of me rambling on. Really hope you did go on to enjoy this episode, regardless of its non-structural point. We just sort of went for it. But we got 1-20 Ferrozino and a 1-20 Raptor. And we made good progress on the egg farm. I can't see shit now, it's so foggy. So guys, regardless of today's video, I really hope you did stick around and you did enjoy. If you did, you know the drill by now. Don't forget to drop a like down below. And guys, if you're new to the channel and you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. So guys, I really hope you enjoy the rest of your day, and I'll be sure to catch you all on the next video.